Hello, and welcome to Lost Connection Voyage to the Stars.
Hello. Hi. So everyone say hello.
So I'm Superman, and I'm joined by Born to be a Loser, a.k.a. Matthew, and Connor,
hello.
A.k.a. Doomsday94.
What's up, guys?
And Alex, also known as Squimp4.
Okay.
So let's start playing. Shall we?
Let's do it then. Well, you do it. I'll sit here.
Yeah. You do a thing.
Yeah.
We'll just heckle.
Yeah. Win all the pies!
So, go. What do we actually want to do?
Well, the music starts.
No, that was just me playing in the Lost Connection theme to get it started.
Okay.
It's doing something else. Stop doing that. Anyway, so what do we want to do? Do we want to build a space station, go exploring the solar system?
I want you to go to the moon.
We can do that.
I want you to do whatever calls you to blow up and die the most. Yeah. Let's start with the moon.
Yes, moon missions aren't too difficult.
He says. Sorry.
Sorry.
Where the
bloody hell was that? You should apologise for that. That was terrible.
I sat on a cat, but I do apologise.
stick a nose cone on top of it, make it look nice.
What the hell? Sure thing.
Pick up the nose cone, please. There we go.
Yeah, this doesn't do aerodynamics, does it?
Not really. No. Aerodynamics in this game, the aerodynamic model in this game is limited, to say the least.
Yeah. Which is just as well, because otherwise it'd be an awful lot harder to build to the moon.
Although saying that, I can't even get out the atmosphere 9 times out of 10.
Is that the right fuel tank on that?
It's because you suck. I don't even play it. That's how amazing I am.
I'm quite good at it when my computer decides it wants to be.
Oh. When... Hang on, let me think.
Oh, to all of our non-existent viewers.
I'm sure they will turn up at some point.
I just want to say that there's actually a new demo available for this. Yeah. It was posted the other day. So if you like what you see, don't download it yet. Continue watching the stream.
Yeah. Good call. Fuel. Good save.
Fuel tanks and fuel lines are into propulsion now, aren't they?
I haven't got a clue what you just said.
Fuel lines used to be under structural, then they moved it to propulsion.
Oh.
You lie.
Okay.
Right, I've got an email.
In other possibly science-related news, I just started a blog, which is basically consisting of me rambling about science, which I'll probably plug at some point, subtly than this.
Yes, plug.
you could have like at least waited until, you know...
But if you give it a refresh, Alex, I've just finished fixing whatever the hell the issue was.
Alright, so... That should work.
Refreshing.
You guys can't hear me drinking, can you?
No. Yeah, I haven't noticed. I hate it.
So I'm going to go with a standard launcher design that I use for a lot of things.
It's a big fuel tank.
Well, I'm going to copy this design then, because whatever I use just doesn't work.
I've seen some really strange designs on this thing.
That's the 45, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, the resolution is so small I can't actually see the whole tooltip, but, you know, don't worry about that.
I've seen some, really messed up designs.
This probably isn't the best design, but it is one that works.
Well, there we go.
if I can get that to attach correctly, yes.
How'd you do that?
Yeah.
It's just turn a tricouple upside down, it will connect to three different things. So.
Yeah, but you were like rotating it.
WASD.
Anything on any game that means move
and
anything.
And Q and E does it as well. So basically the movement controls also turn things around in the vehicle assembly building.
That's
useful. That sure is. That's amazingly useful. This means nothing to me. I didn't even realise that would have been a problem, so...
Main sail underneath. And...
It's probably the single nerdiest way of spending a Valentine's Day evening ever.
I forgot it was Valentine's Day. It was, I was reading the script for the trailer that Gareth sent me. And they said this Valentine's Day. He's like, oh, hell yeah, Valentine's Day.
It's a good job you're single. Otherwise, you would be single now.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think it's also generally good for the population of the planet that he's single.
Hey, coming from you, Gareth.
Ooh. Well, I have my letter through. I have my thing through from Oxford here. My feedback.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the email is very, very slowly loading.
That looks silly enough, right?
That was ages ago, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. This is why I'm now going to read it.
Yeah.
Just to put it out there, is it?
I didn't get the 51%, that's fine.
Because solid rocket, there's no reason not to put solid rocket boosters on whenever you make a rocket. You know, it's like free extra propulsion.
Yeah.
Those that, when they eventually get to career mode and have limited...
Oh, good, that's a condescendingly worded letter. There is a part in this letter that says, however, that although Connor may feel disappointed that he has no... there is no doubt that he's a very good student and need not be discouraged from studying physics or related subject at another top university.
Just not here.
Not that one.
Yeah, that's basically saying...
Never here. Never.
Yeah, go away, commoner, before you stink up the place.
Also, I have an email here from Sussex saying, please come to us. So, you know, swings and roundabouts.
Yes, exactly.
Welcome to Connor's email at Inbox Live.
Yeah. Next on the list, I have an email from PayPal.
Oh yeah, they sent out those this morning, didn't they?
Yeah. Oh. Actually, kind of interesting. I did actually receive a letter this morning on Valentine's Day. It was a memory card I ordered off Amazon.
I got a letter from my mum. She often does that for Valentine's Day. It's funny, because it's just a thing. Except I still find it funny until she does it to me, but my brother doesn't find it funny, so he doesn't get them. But my one said how to please a woman, and then had all these lists of, like, you know, be someone they can confide in and everything. And then underneath said how to please a man, and it said, be naked, bring beer.
Okay, so I think that...
You're right.
Complete. So, what shall we name our first vehicle?
Zoom out a bit so we can get a full look at it.
And then you see it.
Call it Phallus 1.
Yes, that.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Go on. No. I don't know.
Okay, yes! So, the first launch of the Phallus 1. Let me show look at the stage.
I really hope it explodes early.
Yeah.
Let's get the staging right first.
Can it blow up from the top? Like, first. Every single attempt now has to be, like, 2, 3, 4 of the phallus.
Yeah.
And I want to disconnect... Where are we? I want to
disconnect. I wouldn't want to disconnect anything.
Yeah, so disconnect to the urethra.
At that point. So this should work. Oops. Cancel. Do that. Save and launch. I'll just have a drink while we're waiting for it to load.
How does this, like, bar thing in the bottom work? Underneath the video.
TSP may have crashed, or... No, it's back. It just sort of feigns crashing while it tries to load.
Yeah, and then fills up half my swap space.
So, of course, you can't see them because I'm sort of on top of them, but we have Bill Jebediah and Bob down here.
I can see one of them.
Oh, yeah, because this is a new save file, isn't it? So you've got Jeb.
Yes. He hasn't died yet.
So, actually, if anything, now it looks like you're part of the crew.
Yeah.
Except the fact that you're in your bedroom which is clearly not a space capsule.
Yeah.
It's another compartment. It's like in the centre.
I think we need some more appropriate music for the launch of our first spacecraft.
Does it bother me? I've got the thing on mute. I hate hearing echo of myself.
Yeah, I muted it as well.
Let's see if that works.
How did I know you were going to play that?
So
I'm going to turn the music up. I'm going to put the music on so I can hear it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh god, and it is really, like, far behind us as well.
Yeah, it really is.
Yeah, it does.
Oh, the 24-hour was bad, because for a long time I was communicating to them through the stream.
Yeah, it was well,
I just want to try this. Echo!
Anyway, let's go.
I find it really hard to follow what's going on, because...
Ping!
I didn't take ASP down, I can't really hear you over the rocket at the moment.
Yeah.
So on the plus side, it is flying.
And at the moment.
Well, normally by now, I would have died. Either on purpose because I got bored. Or because I'm rubbish.
I'm sure we'll probably get to that point where just crashing rockets are fed.
I hear the moon's called some, like, Mun or Moon or something.
It's called, the Mun.
The Men of the Mute. It's got. Is it got hexes on the U?
Yeah, I put those in occasionally, but it hasn't got them. Oh, there's boosters have been out. So.
Woo!
Drop those.
Thing is, because you're flying vertically up, does that mean everyone who was like stood in the Space Command Center is now dead?
Yes, I may have dropped inside the rocket on the head. But this world seems to be uninhabited apart from Space Center.
Is it like a rival?
You'll live underground.
Yeah. Does that mean that you have essentially got a sign?
What's happened there?
Something just blew off.
My wing fell off.
It looks majestic.
We have a slight spin going on here.
A slight spin?
It's cool.
It's like you 16. Put it in a...
Oh, that's not good.
What? Oh.
That's not really not good.
That wasn't meant to happen.
Can anyone else see, like, the line at the middle of the video?
Yeah, there's a bit of a glitch.
It's kind of cool. Ignore it. Wait.
There he's gone. Done it.
Have you got, like, a parachute on that thing?
Yes, it's still have a parachute. I did put parachutes on this.
This is a really effective way of bombing the other non-existent inhabitants of Kerbal.
Yeah.
Well, it's in development, so they might do that, mightn't they?
I think they might be planning to city at some point.
Yeah.
Squad, that's what squad said. Actually, I can go into proper time warp now, because we're above the atmosphere.
Woo!
And now we hit the atmosphere again.
And,
oh, that was worth it.
Well, that probably would have taken over half an hour,
guys.
Okay.
I want to see him land in the water.
It's kind of weird, though, because splashdowns tend to kill you. A lot more than...
Yeah.
I want to see dead little green men as well.
They just
disappear off the screen. Go away in a puff of smoke.
So, right now, if you could just about see Bill on the side of he looks a bit scared. The great thing about Jeb, he's never scared. Though it does now mean Gareth has to now go rescue Jeb from the sea.
we'll just let the Kerbin Navy do that.
Since when did they have a navy if it's uninhabited?
Since
when has it had the space?
They have a space program.
It's uninhabited.
They're closed.
This is the reason why we haven't actually discovered any on any of the planets. They are there. They just only have one small space center.
Yeah. They're closed.
They also seem to be all male.
Look, the sea issues are rising.
No, I can. It's perfectly fine. It's, you know.
What's your drop speed? 6.9?
Yeah, 6.8. 6.7. It should survive this.
Should.
Then again, I did say this should have made it into orbit with no problem.
So the wind fell off. Damn it, Dave.
So. Let's go back to the vehicle assembly building and see what went wrong.
I think you put the winglets in a check.
It's a goddamn Spotify queuing thing. What have we got? The winglets attached there and they fire. Then. And so the age-old Kerbal solution, if at first it doesn't work, use more struts.
I've never used struts.
Well, that's probably why your things now get off the ground.
No, they get off the ground, I just can't get to orbit.
They go boom.
No, they just run out of
fuel. We have to rename this as well.
Yeah. It's the Phallus 2.
Phallus 2. Phallus 2.
I thought it was the wings that came off. Why are you putting struts on those?
The capsule fell off afterwards.
Oh, right.
That's kind of slightly more concerning than the wings falling off.
I'm going to say wings are quite important too.
Do you have like a budget with this thing?
No, not really. This is what we call sandbox mode at the moment, so...
Yeah, is it? Are there plans for?
Yeah, there are plans for career mode where you have limited
career resources. Modes on the menu.
Yes, it's just grayed out.
Is it the age old way of developers saying, "Here's a feature we're working on but haven't had time to finish yet"?
Yes.
Well, this alpha is alpha.
Okay, is there any way of making like a spaceship that works that doesn't look like a spaceship? You know, like this looks classically like a spaceship. Can you make like some monstrosity and it'll still fly?
You can
fly?
Do space planes. You can
do, yeah, I'm not very good at space planes though.
They're kind of cool.
Good, do a space plane. Let's do a space plane.
Now space planes are really horrible to watch.
Can you do like a flappy thing where it flaps its wings and flies?
No, that'd be cool. Let's see some weird YouTube video of some like exploit using the control surfaces that sort of works like that, but no, you can't make a bird. So put some RCS thrusters on there, that probably won't save things, but
is that just in case it blows up and you've got to save them?
So Phallus 2, let's try again. Yeah, let's get rid of the debris of the last Phallus.
No. So yeah, you did kill people. Does your like space center have a sign saying please bring really big metal umbrellas?
No, that's why people die.
So
every time really... someone goes out to go and put the sign up, something hits them on the head.
Clearly. So, turbines aren't as concerned with health and safety.
Take two.
Hey!
Moving up.
What's the most successful thing any of you have ever done on this thing? Not in life. We'll get onto that.
I once managed to get it to pull, I think, 9G in a spin. It wasn't entirely deliberate, but it was kind of cool.
I went sort of got to Duna and back.
That's quite impressive. It's a long way out.
Even if I did have to rescue the Kerman from the pod in orbit afterwards, but you know.
Can you get into orbit around any planet? Anywhere?
Yes. We'll be demonstrating this if this thing manages to get to the moon this time.
We've got a landing bit
around the moon.
We're just using a... We're just going to land the whole capsule on the moon.
Oh, okay.
The next stage is I want a successful one where you can bring it back and stuff.
This should be, I think.
Yeah, this should work. It does tend to like to roll a lot. it's design. I know. We are 24 meters, 24 kilometers away. We need to get a little bit higher than that.
This game increases in price the more they develop it.
Yeah, it's the standard Minecraft model.
Yeah.
It's a really good game, though.
It's pretty cool. Yeah, it's got character.
I mean, if you don't mind spending an evening trying to crashing into things before you actually make any progress, it's alright.
Well, I just spent the whole half term bored, you know.
This is at 102 meters, so use maneuver nodes.
Yeah, you do that. Then pull one of the blue ones. Pull one of the blue ones as well, go on.
Look, he's going to orbit.
You really, 100 and...
Ooh!
No, let's go that way a bit more. 99.
Pretty cool.
Oh, that'll do. It's not exactly a space station.
Yeah. You only have to orbit for long enough to go around.
Yeah, let's just get roughly circular and in 100 kilometres, because then I can use the old visual assist for getting to the moon.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because from 100 kilometres up, when the moon rises, is about when you need to burn to reach the moon.
Okay. This is the one with the encounter thing on it as well, isn't it?
Yeah. This is 1.8. This is 0.8.2. Sorry.
This isn't even 1.
It's 0.18.2. I'll get the vision number right eventually.
I like how the little pictures, the like stuttery pictures of the little spacemen.
Hey, they're a long way up. You know, it's going to take time for the signal to get back.
I like it. Sort of realistic.
Yeah, actually gotten those. It's actually not even worth keeping it up a stage for like 22 units of fuel. So, goodbye. Oops, come on.
And the moment you do that, you start to spin.
Yeah, those tricouplers tend to induce a spin.
I could probably... That's probably momentum and stuff, isn't it?
I think they just don't all fire synchronously, which is the trouble. Get back in place.
It looks so feeble, those little tiny thrusters.
Yeah.
Those are just RCS, they just stabilise
everything. Yeah, probably start burning now. That's better.
How far are you off your node?
It's node in 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, I'm a bit late.
Congratulations! You're on your node.
Very late.
Science nodes.
They've got about 1 minute and 50 seconds of burning to go.
Yeah. Quite a bit of delta V. I don't know what that actually means, but I've watched a lot of these videos and they talk about delta V all the time.
It's got Manny who talks about delta V a lot.
Yeah, I don't even know what it is.
I think it's just changing velocity, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
I know, but he talked about it as like that you have a certain amount of delta V. I'm like, but what?
If you take the amount of thrust your rocket generates, the amount of fuel you have, and you can change your velocity by a certain total amount, or something like that. I don't know.
Circularizing.
Hopefully,
we'll at some point we'll have to show Matt the secret moon, like the secret base on the other side of Kirby.
I've never actually been.
Oh, we get to show you as well then, Gareth.
I know of it, I've never been there. Yes, because I fucked up waiting for the node, this may fail.
Yeah, it doesn't look like it's going to go too well.
Are we going to make it time or...? It's getting around here, but...
You should angle up.
I'm just following the blue. I'm just following the blue dot.
You might just make it.
Yes, we will. Hopefully. I'll be in a horrible orbit, but we'll make it.
Here we go.
We ran out of fuel. we have these nuclear rockets.
They're like, it's getting smaller and smaller as you run out of fuel.
The nuclear rockets are rubbish.
They're efficient, but
there's not enough thrust.
Let's just say that. Let's just call that one. Take three, and this time let's time it right when we get to node.
I timed it perfectly, and I don't even know what I'm talking about. It was you, Gareth. You failed.
This is just the moon. Yeah. Right? You wait till we're going further, right?
Yeah, that's why I set my, on the moon. I haven't heard much about this game, but apparently it's difficult, so the moon.
Well, that's going out, we're taking a quick tour of the solar system. We have the moon, we have Minmus, and then we have the planets, Moho, Eve, Juno, Dres, which is like a little asteroid thing, Jewel, and Elu.
By the end of this, you have to get to the furthest one.
Yeah, and I can't remember who's got moons. Jewel, being a gas giant, obviously has moons. I think Dres has a moon.
Does it?
Yeah.
Which is the tiny asteroid one?
I'm not Dres, sorry. Juno has a moon, Dres is a tiny asteroid.
Can you go into orbit around a moon that's orbiting a planet?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what he's
going to do. I forgot I've already asked that, haven't I? Yeah. I asked that about the moon. Right, I want you to go into orbit by the end of this around the furthest moon from the furthest planet.
Well, we can get out to Elu. I haven't managed to do it. I've only barely made the Duna after all, so you know.
Well, this is the moment of truth, Gareth.
But before we do that, I want you to fly into the sun.
Do you have any idea the ridiculous amounts of delta V that takes?
Lots of delta V.
Thought I heard explode. That's not good.
Something's gone.
Okay.
There are no other people watching.
What's going on?
I don't care. Gareth is failing horribly.
This normally works better than this.
Take four.
This is cool. And
we gotta go all.
See, this is what happens to me. I never make it to orbit.
Go all the way out to apoapsis and then all the way back down.
Yes, it could be a long wait.
Only up to 99 kilometers.
At which point they go, "Hey, I can see my house up from here." Oh God, no!
Well, they still have their parachutes. That's something.
Pull the parachutes now.
They won't deploy for a while.
Yeah, you can trigger them as early as you like. It's just an ages.
Yeah, they're triggered now, but they won't deploy until we get lower. And there's the debris of the rest of the rocket falling down in front of me. And there go the parachutes. Pulling quite a few G's there.
Serious whiplash.
Let's have a look at this from inside the capsule.
Oh, cool.
I think we hit the ground. And that's what that sound was. No, and what was that? The top of the rocket fell off.